Okay guys, in my last video I have discussed about the failure pattern of bracing, and you know that due to the tensile force and compressive force the failures mainly occurred. And after watching the video, one of you have asked me that, sir, how to find whether the member of the brace is in tension or in compression. Okay, and this video is going to be all about that. So if you're new to this channel, please do subscribe and also don't forget to press the bell icon so that in future you can be benefited. Okay, so to understand how to find the tensile force or the compressive force, we will simply cut a section in this frame, and here you can see this is the lateral load and this bracing is going to carry this lateral load. Now how this bracing is going to carry this lateral load, whether through compression or through tension, that is the question. Now after cutting the section, simply draw the free body diagram. So the free body diagram looks something like this. Okay, so these are the part of the column. This is column 1, this is column 2, and this is the strut. Okay, all the joints are pin joint. Here we have the lateral load and this is the bracing. Okay, so let's say we will assume that if the force is away from the joint, in that case it is tension, and if the force is towards the joint, in that case it is compression. The simple convention that is used in truss force member analysis also. Okay, so if this is the joint, let's say we are assuming that the force is away from the joint, or we are assuming that in this member the force is, yes, tensile force. So if this is away from the joint, in that case it will have a horizontal component like this and vertical component like this. So if we take the summation of horizontal forces is equals to zero from equilibrium equation, in that case this is the lateral load P and this is the horizontal component of the bracing, let's say BH. So P, let's say the convention is towards right, it is positive, then P minus BH, because BH is acting towards left side, BH is equals to zero. That means BH is going to be P equals to P. Okay, so here the BH is equals to P and our convention is correct, or assumption is correct. So this is going to be under tension. Okay, and what is the magnitude of this tensile force? Simply, if you know this angle, this angle is theta, in that case the tension is simply PH divided by cos theta. That is the value of the tensile force. Okay, and now I am giving you a simple home task. If this is the lateral load in this diagonal bracing, what is going to be the force in this member? Okay, and I am giving you the same clue. Simply you have to cut it and you have to apply the equilibrium equation in this section, and you will find it whether it is under tension or compression. Simply calculate yourself and let me know. If you are unable, of course I will help you. So if you love this video, don't forget to share it.